In U.S. federal immigration proceedings, you are not guaranteed legal counsel, even if you are a child, seeking asylum, or detained.
As a result, 71% of immigrants in detention and appearing at the Aurora Immigration Court go unrepresented. Colorado received immigration court cases for more than 4,800 people in 2018. Two-thirds lacked legal representation. Yet 87% of Metro Denver residents support government-funded legal defense for all, regardless of legal status. The Denver Immigrant Legal Services Fund was created to ensure access to immigration representation or affirmative immigration relief for Denver residents.
In August 2017, I signed the Denver Public Safety Enforcement Priorities Act into law, memorializing existing city policies and practices, in addition to establishing new policies that we hope will reduce fear within the immigrant community and clarify for everyone that Denver will not engage in immigration enforcement.
Immigrants with legal representation are 10 times more likely to be able to stay in the country with legal defense. Through the Denver Immigrant Legal Services Fund, these organizations provide services to immigrants facing deportation who could not otherwise afford representation.
If it weren't for them, right now it would be a very sad situation for me and my family.
Yo no lo podía creer, tantas cosas, tanta ayuda. Es increíble, mucha gente no sabe. Yo creo que todo migrante que llega aquí, que no pase por esta organización, pasa mucho trabajo.
The fund has helped over 270 Denver residents and their families over the past 2 years. Immigrants make up more than 16% of the Denver population, contributing to our culture and economy. The Denver Immigrant Legal Services Fund was established to protect our communities by ensuring all community members the rights that were granted to them by the U.S. and Colorado constitutions, working to ensure children stay with their families, and fostering trust between community members and city officials. The Denver Immigrant Legal Services Fund is generously supported by donations, the Vera Institute of Justice, the Denver Foundation, and the City of Denver. For more information, visit denverfoundation.org.